Matter standard, which was formerly known as Connected Home over IP or CHIP, is a smart home royalty-free standard announced back in 2019. The main goal of Matter is to achieve interoperability between smart home and IoT devices from different vendors. In other words, using a Matter standard, devices produced from different vendors, let's say Apple and Google, will be able to talk to each other natively. This is the every maker wet dream. Unfortunately, Matter is still not publicly released. The good thing is that most of the major smart home vendors like Amazon, Apple, Google, Samsung, IKEA, Zigbee and many more are committed to help with releasing this Matter standard. And most probably, they'll make their new generation devices Matter ready. That is why there is so much noise around Matter standard, and it is more than great that Home Assistant crew is making efforts to implement Matter inside Home Assistant. What Nabucasa team actually did is a Home Assistant Matter workshop, where they show how the Matter integration is currently working inside Home Assistant. They also provided some instructions and requirements in case someone wants to try Matter. And this is exactly what we are going to do in this video. Let's start! These are the official Matter workshop instructions that the Home Assistant crew provided, and here we have some requirements. These requirements were announced several days before the actual workshop, so we had time to prepare for this. And let's start with the first one. We need to have Home Assistant operating system 8.0 or newer. To check that, go to your Home Assistant, press the C button, type System Health, and under Host Operating System you find your Home Assistant OS version. Of course, it is totally possible that you are not using Home Assistant OS installation type at all. If you want to know more about the different installation types, check my free webinar where I am explaining everything. Here is the installation type actually, and we are fine with that first requirement. Next requirement is the Bluetooth support. I have Raspberry Pi, which have Bluetooth embedded on board, and I'm fine with that. If you don't have Raspberry Pi or something with embedded Bluetooth, you have to buy some additional Bluetooth USB stick. For example, this one, TP-Link UB500. Next requirement is Home Assistant Community Store or Hux. I have a video about how to install Hux in your Home Assistant. If you don't have it yet, go check this video. You'll find the link somewhere here. Following the instruction there, you can add Hux in no time. Next requirement is Wi-Fi network. I have Wi-Fi. And the next one is ESP32 device plus USB2 serial drivers installed. I will use this ESP32 C3 DevKit M1 device. This one, and this is the actual chip. This is a dev board. I'm going to use that, and I'm good to go. We are done checking the requirements. Let's start with the actual steps that needs to be implemented. The first step is to add the development repository using this My Home Assistant link, which is generously provided by the Home Assistant crew in this workshop Matter instructions. I'll click on this, and this My Home Assistant IO page is immediately open. If you click on this pencil button right here, you can edit the URL of your Home Assistant in order to make this My Home Assistant link to work. Basically, you just have to enter the IP of your Home Assistant and the port and then to hit update. That way, My Home Assistant link will work from now on for you. It doesn't matter if the address is local or not, you just have to add it. And when you do that, you just have to click this open link, which will open this Manage at Repository dialog with populated repository URL. And I just have to click Add here. Immediately, these add-ons below are shown because I just added the Home Assistant developer repository. Once again, the Home Assistant Matter integration is still experimental. A lot of things will be probably changed until the actual release of Matter. but I believe everything will be more polished and streamlined by then. All of my respect is going to the Nabucasa team, because they throwing efforts at the matter at this stage, making Home Assistant even more future ready. One of the add-ons here is called the Matter Server, and I'll click on this. This add-on provides a Matter controller which allows to commission and control Matter devices, exactly what we needed, and I'll hit Install. The Matter Server add-on is installed and I just have to click Start. Next step is to install Matter integration. For that we need Home Assistant Community Store or HAX. I'll copy this link right here. Copy link. The Matter server is already installed and started, as you can see from here. And this is my HAX installation. Again, if you don't have HAX yet, just go and watch my video tutorial about it. I have also an article about that on my website. You can check it as well. I'll click on this. I'll go to the integration section, three dots menu, custom repositories, and I'll paste the URL in the repository field. As category, I'll choose integration, and I'll click on the add button. Great, the Matter experimental repository is now added. I'll close this, and then I'll click explore and download repositories. I'll click on this, and then on download this repository with HAX. Download. The Python server that interacts with Matter is now ready to use, and it is already in my HAX. And I have this pending restart, but I'll not restart, I'll just hit refresh the browser. If that is not helping me, I'll have to restart, but let's try this. The next step is to add the Matter experimental integration. I can go to this menu, or I can click this My Home Assistant link. This is faster. Open link. Do you want to set up a Matter experimental? Okay. I'll wait for this a bit. And now I have this URL. I'll not change anything. I'll just click submit here. And then finish. This is my Matter experimental integration. So far so good. Let's see what is the next step. We reach the step 3, which is to create your Matter light. Now I have to connect my ESP32 device using a USB cable. Okay, I'm going to do that. It is connected now. Don't forget to download the drivers for this ESP board. You can find the links here. If your board is Espressif ESP32 C3 DevKit M1, click on this link. If it is M5 Stamp C3, click on this link. If you click on it, you go to the Silicon Labs page, and from download section, you can download the drivers for Windows or for macOS. For Linux, everything should work out of the box. The installation of these drivers for Windows and Mac is very trivial. You just have to click next several times. Let's continue. Where were we? Here. I'll copy this link and I'll open this in Chrome or Edge. These are the only supported browsers. By default, I'm using Safari web browser for everything, but it will not work for this exact task. And this is the Chrome browser, and in the search bar, I'll paste the URL. And this is the page that Home Assistant Crew provided for flashing the ESP32 board. It is powered by ESP Web Tools. I have a video about ESP Web Tools as well, if you wish to know more about it. It is a very useful tool that makes the flashing of ESP32 boards very easy. I'll click on this first bullet because I'm having ESP32 C3 DevKit M1, and I'll click Connect. I have two devices right here because I think I installed the drivers twice, once during this workshop and once in the past, so it doesn't matter which one will I choose. In your case, you should have only one device, so choose that device and click Connect. Then select Logs and Console and type the following command. I'll copy it because I'm too lazy to type it. Matter onboarding codes BLE. I'll paste the command here. And this is what I need. This is the QR code that I will copy because I'll need this later. Okay, I copy that and I'll go to the instructions. We reach the step 4, pair your Matter light. In Home Assistant, go to DevTools Services or use this My Link. I'll use the link. As service, I'll search for Wi-Fi. This one, MatterExperimental.setWiFi. And I'll enter my Wi-Fi credentials here. The Wi-Fi name is A. And this is my password. And I'll click on Call Service. Let's see what is the next step. It is to call another service called Commission Device with the QR code string that we get from the previous step. Okay. I'll search for Commission. Matter Experimental Commission. Here it is. This is the correct service. And I'll paste the QR code that I have from the previous step. Have in mind that the code is not only these digits and characters after the colons, but it also includes the empty and then something. I'll click on Call Service. And I think I'm ready. If I go to the Home Assistant integration section, and if I find the Matter integration, I'll see one device and one entity. Dimmable light. I can add this to my dashboard right here. I can change the name. This is the device info, ESP32C3 DevKit M1 lighting app by Nabucasa. And let's see if it is going to work. I'll click on this switch. And the LED is turned on and off. Great. If I go to my overview section, I can decrease the brightness of the LED and I can increase it. Great. I can even press the boot button. Which one was it? This one. If I press it, the dimmable light is also turned on in Home Assistant, so everything is in sync. Of course, I can add automations, scripts, and scenes with this device, but this is not needed. The main idea here was to test Matter inside Home Assistant. Everything is still experimental. I really hope to see the Matter standard released to general public very soon because it is very exciting and a lot of people are awaiting it like a hot breath. If some of the terms and abbreviations that I used during this video are not so clear for you, you can check my free smart home glossary available on my website. Go there, enter your email and receive the smart glossary in your inbox absolutely for free. I will see you next Wednesday when I release my new smart home related video. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!